there are so many shorts and TikToks out there about art, and some of them are really good. They teach the viewer a tip, a technique, or give some advice about the medium. Sometimes. Other times I find myself confused and triggered by some of these shorts. Now, no one is perfect. We progress and we grow and we learn, and we will never achieve absolute perfection. However, there are some things that need to be addressed. So today we're going to look at some watercolor shorts and see what's getting those views. Disclaimer. A lot of artists have their own style and their own unique way to make art, and that is perfectly fine. It works for them. But remember, there is no one size fit all. If their methods don't work for you, it doesn't mean that you're bad at art, and it doesn't always mean that they're wrong. I follow a lot of watercolor artists that use the loose watercolor method. I don't have the patience for it. I like sketching my pieces beforehand, and it's mainly because I started in traditional art and it helps guide me when I watercolor. Am I wrong? No. Are they wrong? No. So I'm not gonna bombard them and tell them that their way is wrong and my way is superior. However, if they do say something like, "This is the way, and I know another way," I'm going to mention it. All right, that's enough chatting. Let's get to it. If you
suck at water, all right, now this one is a good exercise to do. Random shapes all over the page, and we're not gonna worry about it. First off, I am starting with a smaller piece of paper. It's just a less intimidating, and you can just put the shapes wherever you want in whatever color you want.
Draw any random shapes and use colors of your own choice.
I don't think I had the same idea as they had. And that's perfectly all right. We can work with this. So I kept on thinking and seeing Stardew Valley and Animal Crossing. So I decided to make it like a little plot of land someone might own. I don't think mine's going to look pretty, but I'll take cute. I didn't add more leaves, but I kind of like how it turned out. This one was simple and easy to understand. I really like this. I'm not really great at florals and I need to work on my leaf game. So this was a nice little exercise for me to try to do different types of leaves. And as you can see, I could still struggle a bit. Leaves come in so many different shapes and sizes, but there are a good many of them, especially in florals, that you can use just one simple brush stroke. And that's what she's showing here, and I love that. Just be careful with puddling though. If you let puddling dry on your watercolor, it will leave darker spots like this. Rebel Unicorn Crafts is very good at explaining watercolor. If you have not subscribed to her already, do so now. She has very fun activities to do and very easy to understand the basics of watercolor. I really have learned some things about it. And again, it's another floral tutorial, but it was really fun to do. I found myself just happy to paint a sunflower. Even if it's like simplistic in a way, I still enjoyed it. So definitely recommend this one. Okay, this one had me stumped for a while. That's why we kept on seeing the short over and over again, because I'm trying to figure out what is going on here. Now it says easy watercolor painting, and I get that. However, I don't think it's exactly watercolor. One of the reasons I think that is that if you put on watercolor, it is more transparent. Now I think what is happening here is that they are using gouache instead of watercolor. Technically gouache is watercolor, however it is much more opaque and you're able to build on darker colors with lighter colors, as you can see here. And again, there's nothing wrong with this piece, it's absolutely gorgeous. I just wish that some watercolor gouache artists would mention that it is gouache, because a lot of watercolor newbies will consider that you're supposed to apply so much thick paint onto their piece when they shouldn't. Lastly, I want to talk about this short, and this was one of the shorts that inspired me to make this video. Again, there is nothing wrong with her piece. It looked very pretty. I liked it a lot. Fine, however, the techniques they're using are probably better used in a different medium, specifically acrylic. I noticed the way that how their brush strokes were and how much paint they were applying and how they were working on each section of the piece. And I was confirmed that when I checked their channel and found out they also worked with acrylics. And again, that's fine. However, with watercolor, you want to use a little less paint. It kind of works your paper a little bit much and it doesn't blend as well as it should. Again, it's a lovely piece. However, I would suggest a little less watercolor. Less is more in this medium.
That's it for this video. This was really fun. I actually learned some things today, and that's a win in my book. And I hope you learned some things as well. If you'd like me to look at more watercolor shorts, let me know in the comments below and I'll take a look at them. I'll definitely do this again. See you next week.